All right, let's do the derivative for cotangent x. Well, cotangent x is the same as cosine x over sine x. So that will be the change first. So let's go ahead and write that down right here. Again, this is cosine x over sine x. And because once we have this change, we can just go ahead and use the quotient rule. The bottom function is sine x. And then the top function is cosine x. So I'll denote that by f. So we have cosine x. All right, the derivative of sine x is positive cosine x. And then the derivative of cosine x, well, this right here will give us negative sine x. And now we have the ingredients. Let's go ahead. First, draw the fraction bar, and then we are going to square the bottom. So I will put this down as sine x, and then we square that. Next, we see that we do this times that. So I will put down the sine x right here. And we multiply this by negative sine x. So perhaps I'll put down parentheses just to emphasize that we are multiplying a negative. And then next, we have to minus this times that. So we have cosine x times this cosine x. So that's what we have. And now, is there anything that we can do? Yes, have a look. Of course, sine x times sine x, that's negative sine x squared. So let me just write that down. And then this is negative, and then we have cosine squared x. Both of them have negative, so we can factor that out. So we are going to see that this is just going to be negative parentheses, and we have sine squared x plus, because we factor out negative right here already, and then we have cosine squared x, and all over sine squared. Sine x squared is the same as if you put a 2 right here, so I will do that right here. And ladies and gentlemen, what's this? This is the famous identity, right? Because sine squared x plus cosine squared x, this is just nicely equal to 1. So in fact, we have just negative 1 on the top over sine squared x. And we know 1 over sine is cosecant, and 1 over sine squared is just cosecant squared, right? So all in all, this right here will give us negative, and then we have again, cosecant square, and then the input is x, just like that. And that's the derivative for cotangent.